Firstly, Mark, thank you for this opportunity, for this wonderful event. As President of Comites South Australia, I congratulate you for having organized what could be, in fact, once again in South Australia, the first of an important new development which is bringing together. And we don't need necessarily a Chamber of Commerce to do that. Business, research, university, and industry and community. And I say this because South Australia has been the first, for instance, to organize the forum for parliamentarians of Italian background. And once again, if we look at the opportunities to bring together all sides of, all aspects, all sides of society and the Italian community, we can achieve positive results. Collaboration, reciprocity, mutual advantage, and most of all, cooperation. At a time of great difficulty, though, we can forget that we are living a period where globalization has been questioned for many, many years, globalization for the social content that was sometimes disregarded because corporations were basically pushing the agenda for globalization. Now we are looking at national domestic interests, selfish political agendas of state and nations that are questioning the very essence of a global world, which means opportunities like the opportunity that we have seen today. And all of that is not only a political issue, it's becoming increasingly even a social, cultural, and everyday issue. If you had problems with your visa, and if your situation in relation to coming to Australia, Sergio, would have been made difficult by changes in the Australian legislation, for instance, which might happen, or if the citizenship debate is pushed forward again as limiting dual citizenship or limiting the opportunity to become an Australian citizen or an Italian citizen in Italy, and I'm not here discussing specific aspects of political parties in Australia or in Italy, but if that happens, certainly the opportunities are further restricted. So keeping that in mind and the fact that politics has still a role and the populists have started to win elections, the populists have started to push an agenda which goes against the principles that we have been discussing today, and even the more progressive and centrist and moderate political parties are now starting to reassess their own policy decisions. And that is a concern that we have to address and keep in mind in the discussion that we have had today. Australia is a wonderful country in terms of opportunities. You have witnessed it in reality. We have many agreements in place in terms of cultural exchanges, in terms of promotion of the Italian language from the Italian Minister of Foreign Affairs and various states. We have a fiscal agreement that avoids double taxation. We have a social security agreement. There was never any need for an agreement to protect investments, probably because I'm not discounting the possibility that one day we might need it, but possibly because the two countries have been cooperating and there is no need to have such an agreement in place. We have, however, government decisions that sometimes have restricted opportunities. And every time that we have made a step forward in the food industry, for instance, in the importation of food from Italy, every time that we have made a step forward, the opportunities have increased. So if we increase the exchange and the business opportunities, we can increase research and development, and the two go together, there is no doubt. From my perspective, as a member of the Italian Parliament, I've been trying to promote those opportunities. So thank you for your presence here today. I have two colleagues from the state parliament, Vincent Tarzia and Tony Piccolo. We have been working together on many aspects of the Italian community inside Australia. I am offering my political experience, which has now been 10 years of Italian parliament, as a possibility, as another opportunity to increase those exchanges and those investment opportunities. We are organizing a forum in Italy for the first time, looking at experiences from researchers and business and industry. So if Mark, you assist me in the process, I'll be more than happy to showcase South Australia and the opportunities that we have had in this state and in Australia. Thank you very much for your attention, and posso aggiungere qualcosa in italiano, mi dispiace. È stata un'esperienza importante e significativa per me questa di oggi. Credo che sia utile ripercorrerla e costruire attorno a questa iniziativa uno sviluppo, diciamo, teorico ma anche pratico di questa collaborazione di cui abbiamo tutti parlato in molti modi, anche sotto il profilo linguistico e culturale. Il Ministero degli Esteri si sta dotando di uno strumento, una nuova direzione generale che mette insieme la promozione linguistico-culturale e quella degli scambi commerciali e della internazionalizzazione. Secondo me è un primo passo. Dobbiamo naturalmente seguire questi sviluppi perché spesso se la guida politica non è stabile e forte, ed è per questo che abbiamo bisogno di una guida, di una leadership politica in Italia che sia stabile e forte, non ci siamo riusciti con il referendum, ma forse ci riusciremo ristabilendo un ordine, diciamo, di grandezza rispetto alle forze politiche che sono in campo e che vedremo confrontarsi alle prossime elezioni nel 2018. E dovremo quindi assicurarci che la burocrazia non prenda in mano tutto e che ci sia una guida anche politica da parte nostra. Le occasioni non mancano, così come le preoccupazioni. Sulla Brexit io credo che dobbiamo avere un'attenzione, dobbiamo evitare che questo evento si trasformi nell'evento della storia dell'Unione Europea, che sia invece un evento che serve per rafforzare l'Unione Europea, e l'Italia è al primo posto in questo impegno nel rafforzare l'Unione Europea. Naturalmente l'Italia pone all'Unione Europea alcune priorità, che sono quelle dello sviluppo, degli investimenti per la crescita, e sono quelle del avere uno sguardo attento a quello che avviene nel movimento delle migrazioni e delle persone, perché l'Italia ha una responsabilità diretta nel salvare vite umane e vuole anche una responsabilità di tutta l'Unione Europea nell'assolvere questo compito e questa responsabilità politica. Per queste ragioni continueremo a svolgere con impegno il nostro lavoro, anche a nome del senatore Giacobbe, che non è qui con me oggi. Vi ringrazio per questa opportunità e seguiremo con attenzione il vostro lavoro. Grazie.